We're going to get the oil change on the truck, and hopefully if we have time tomorrow, we'll wash the truck too. Been kind of running this week, you know, because of the PM. PM is done on Friday, like I said, and today's Thursday. And we tried to do 5 days worth of work in four. So we're trying. So we're running a little bit this week, but I have enough time to shoot. I have enough time to shoot you. So that was kind of gay, wasn't it? I'm sorry. I'm sorry. All right, let's get rolling. Let's go down this U.S. Highway 281. Let's go. I'm going to go in here and grab a no-no. You know, I'm not supposed to have Dr. Peppers, but I enjoy some every now and then, and that's what I'm going to do. Shh. Don't tell my wife I got a Dr. Pepper. Don't.
Got in key. Yes.
Well, I just got done here at my first drop. I had 23 pallets and I tailgated all 23. Nice workout. A lot of drivers complain about it. Ah. I should have to back up in the dock and do nothing. I enjoy it. Now, I don't enjoy hand loading crap, but you know, you hand me a pallet jack, I'll unload it, whatever. I enjoy it. 23 pallets. These are small pallets. These are not the great big old pallets, you know, regular size. They're small, hold about five doors standing up on them, and yeah. Nice little workout. I got three more drops to go. Usually 23 pallets, we don't have that many. This is just a special order. They said, I ain't got room for on the dock. So let's go back here and to the lumber side and we'll go ahead and take them off back there. You don't mind that? I was like, no, I actually prefer that. Most drivers don't like that. Well, I understand because most drivers are lazy. I try not to be lazy. You get fat being lazy. So it's a good workout. Sure. All right, I'm gonna go and to drop number two.
Only my heart, call back my rose, rose of sand and tone. Lips so sweet and tender, like petals falling apart. Speak once again of my love, my own broken song. Into words I know, still live in my heart all alone.
Yes,
but that moon. Still live in my heart all alone. But that moonlit path by the Alamo and rose my rose of San Antone.
Oh, San Antone.
All right, we're done. Let's drop. All done. We're going to get out here. Shut the nose. And head back up to Dallas, get this PM done on this truck, change my tires. walking in Dallas and the sun is down. The sun is down. Can you believe that stuff? The sun is down. 7 o'clock, it's dark. Like, it's been dark for 3 hours and it's just like depressing. So I'm ready for summertime to get here, but I'm not ready for the temperatures. I like it chilly. You know what's going to go in that hole right there.
It's 12:43 in the morning. Time's a ticking. Truck's in the shop. But got a call about 9 o'clock from support shift, and they said, you're going to do a load tomorrow, 7 a.m. Okay. It'd be nice if you asked. I asked why, what's going on. I said, driver called in sick or something. So you're doing it. I said, all right, well, truck's in the shop. And I didn't tell him I would do it. Tell him we'll see. That's what I said. I tell him we'll see. He says, okay. Hung up the phone. A couple hours later, I called and said, the lady picked up. She said, I told her what was up. I said, hey, it'll probably be 1, 2, 3 o'clock before this thing's done, the truck's done, in the shop. And she was like, big deal. You can't do it? Why not? I said, it's on 2-3 hours of sleep. Yeah, but you'll still be there on time. And I just hung up the phone. I was just like, so I called her up about an hour later. I said, hey, if I do this load, I'm going to be late. Again, I had to explain to her that I am going to get a full night's sleep before I go driving all day long tomorrow, because I've been working all day today, up since 6, you know, and then going all day today. So, here you go. It's 12:45. Pretty well off where I'm at, but, you know, those are the ones I'm really concerned for. And first drop. It's Greenville, Texas, 7 a.m. in the morning. So, as of right now, that ain't gonna happen. Now, I called her and told her, she said, all right, we'll see what we could, let's see if I can find someone to cover your load. If not, you're just gonna have to be late all day tomorrow. All right, that's just what it's gonna have to happen, because like I said, we'll be up until 2-3 o'clock tonight at the earliest, maybe even later, who knows. And just to do that, no. So anyways, standing around, these old dispatchers, you know, try to push you like that. 2:07. Load's still on there. Let's go see if it's still in here. They moved it in here, changed tires and stuff. They had to hood up a while ago. Yep. Still working on it. It's 4 o'clock in the morning. I've been up for 22 hours. 22 hours. So, they're thinking, I'm going to go deliver this load at 7 o'clock? In 3 hours, I'm supposed to be there? This tired puppy's going to bed. It's 4 o'clock. 4 o'clock in the morning. And which is fine, I expected that when they said, hey, you want to take the truck early and,
you know? Duh. But then when they called, someone called up in Green Bay, you know, they said, you're doing this. I don't know. Now, if they would have made me wait to have the truck in, you know, for service until tomorrow, which is today, I would have said, oh, you know, all right, I'll do that load. We'll cancel the service. But you know how it goes. So I'm going to write an email to my bosses. Got two bosses. And make sure they both get it. That's the reason why. And so when they get there in the morning, they've already got an email from me. I'm going to send them another email saying, hey, this is where I'm at. So, you know, either keep it on me and this load's going to be very late, or give it to someone else. Because I'm not going to get no 3-4 hours. I'm going to get at least 6 hours. So that's going to put us at 10 o'clock. 7 o'clock appointment. So we'll see how that goes. All right, I'm going to bed. Well, I don't know if you can tell or not, but made it off that load. I guess she woke up, she got to the office this morning. They took it off. Put it on someone else, so that's that stress. Stressing out about. Because I don't like that. I don't like saying I can't do something. You know, it's just, it's hard for me to do. But there's a safety aspect out here. And you know, you just got to cover your own self, you know. CYA. So anyways, we're here at the Blue Beacon in Dallas, the streaking beacon. We're going to get this truck washed. Here at the Dallas OC, every time you get a PM done, you go get a truck wash over here at the streaking beacon. So that's what we're going to do for Friday. And we're going to go get our, pick up our Monday's load and go into the house. So thanks for watching. Trucker HU88 here. And we'll see you next time. 73.